Hello everyone, welcome to the Learn Biology Online, and today we're going to discuss about the enzyme kinetics. So today I'm going to discuss about this enzyme kinetics in a summary way, not in the detail, because it is required in detail when we are doing graduation in zoology or in any other subject which is related to biology and in masters. So if any student want me to discuss in detail, then they can write their comments in the comment box, so I can make another video in a later slides. So let's discuss. This is an enzyme and this is a substrate. So as we know, the enzyme has a active site and this substrate will bind to the enzyme and they form a ES complex. Okay, this is going a forward reaction. So when the ES will come together and form a ES complex, and the constant that we use at this time for representing the forward reaction is K plus K1. Okay, now we know this ES complex is a E having a catalytic property which breaks the substrate bond and form a product. So this enzyme will remove as such and product will form. Now this is also a forward reaction which is basically from ES complex to the product formation. Then we represent by the constant K2. Okay. Sometimes what happens is AS complex is not as such stable and it break down into the enzyme and the substrate again. And this reverse reaction has been shown with the help of K-1. Okay, this backward reaction is shown by the K-1, while the forward reaction by the K1 and the K2 when product will form. Here, this is the equation. This is a Michaelis-Menten's equation that having a V0. V0 means initial velocity. Okay, Vmax, so maximum velocity at a particular substrate, we call it Vmax. This is a substrate, and Km is Michaelis-Menten's constant, and S is again a substrate. So remember this equation, this is very important. So let's discuss about that, how this Km, define it. So if, just take an example, if V0 is Vmax by 2. Okay, just take an example. Okay, now this V0 will come, so at this position, this V0 becomes a Vm by 2, and this Vm plus S, Km plus S. Now this Vm will, cut it with this Vm, and this will remain. And finally, this Km become a equal to the substrate concentration. That means, this whole equation means, it is that substrate concentration. Km means, it is that substrate concentration which is required to achieve a half Vmax. So, Km is a substrate concentration which is required to achieve a half Vmax. We call them Km, that is Michaelis-Menten's constant. Just look at here, this is a y-axis and this is a x-axis. At the x-axis we have a substrate, while at a y we have an initial velocity. Okay, this is a reaction which has been this is a reaction. Now here you can see this is a Vmax, when there's a saturation level came, when number of the substrate that is present is is basically bound with enzymes. So all the substrate is bound with the enzyme, there is no free, so this is a Vmax condition, velocity reached at maximum. Now at, if V0 is Vm2, when the Vmax is half, at the time we can determine the Km. I told you the definition. Now this is a Km. So if the reaction will take, like this, if it is a reaction like this, if the Km will be more, then reaction will take a more time to reach at the Vmax. So by this we can define that Km is indirectly proportional to the affinity of the substrate for enzyme. That means if Km is more, that means the affinity of substrate for enzyme will be less. So when we want an enzyme that is more efficient, then we first need that Km should be less. Km, if Km is less, means it requires less substrate to fill Vmax, and it will be a helpful in the reaction also. So remember this, Km is indirectly proportional to the affinity of substrate for enzyme. Now, by using a Michaelis-Menten equation, we cannot find the exact value of Vmax. According to the scientists, we cannot find the exact value of the Vmax. So there is another plot that scientist has developed to finding the exact value of the Vmax, and it is a reciprocal of Michaelis-Menten equation. Let's see. Here, this is a Michaelis-Menten equation, V naught is equal to Vmax S and upon Km plus S. Now reciprocate this reaction. V naught will become 1 by V naught. This Vmax will come, you know, at the lower side, while the Km will move to the numerator. Here, this V naught is come to the denominator, and this Km upon Vm S and S upon Vms. So S is cancelled by the S, and this whole reaction has been achieved. This reaction. And you can compare with a straight line reaction. So you can see Y is equal to Mx plus C. So Y will come here, MxC, Mx is this, and C is this. Now put like this. So we know that Y is present at V naught. So Y axis pe we have a V, 1 upon V naught. While at X axis we have a 1 upon S. And this is the intercept. That is 1 upon Km for X axis and 1 upon Vm for Y axis. Okay. So if we want to find the X axis intercept, then we need to put this 0. We need to put this 0 if we want to find the x-axis intercept. As in, same like if we want to find the y-axis intercept, we need to keep x-axis intercept 0. So this is a line weaver work plot, and I hope you will understand what I will, you know, what I will teach today. And if you have any confusion regard anything, you can message me in the comment box. So I can put them in the next video, and thank you so much.